of Europe has been crushed under the Axis boot, forcing an Allied retreat. Their supply lines for food and raw materials are crippled. The Suez Canal is a lifeline, connecting Britain with its empire and Middle Eastern oil, making the war in North Africa crucial. As the British and Axis armies face each other across the Libyan-Egypt border, the front line swings like a pendulum across the Western Desert. A harsh, unforgiving strip of land between the Mediterranean and the Sahara. Mechanized warfare has come of age. Here, tanks are king. I've arrived in Tobruk, off a boat filled with replacements and reinforcements. Young men blindly rushing to their deaths. None of them are comfortable having someone like me around. Suits me fine. Most of them won't make it out if you're alive. Rommel was kicked out during Operation Crusader, but Axis forces are once again sweeping across the Western Desert. The Gazala Gallop began with the Allied retreat, and Rommel is at the city's throat. There's no time for tactics. 35,000 of us have one order. Hold Tobruk.
A little bit of this game. Haven't beaten it though, and I thought that it would be nice considering that most of my videos are Total War based, just to kind of get a first person shooter on there. So yeah, let's get into this. Here. So destroy vehicles by shooting weak spots. Tag vehicles to highlight these. Some weak spots may require multiple shots. So I don't know. I think it is the binoculars. Itself is really crisp and clean. I do enjoy the graphics. So I think this game is a couple of years old. Find a route through the mountain pass. Okay.
The Germans are using Nebelwerfers. I need to do something about them.
The look sensitivity needs to be turned down just a bit. That's okay.
If I crouch.
This game is really close to Tom Clancy's
My wall rod's quiet. I should use it.
In the fact that you really have to plan. Oh yeah, so this is just showing you the different ratings. You really have to plan how you're going to go about things. Can't really just go in guns blazing. I find for people that really enjoy sniper classes in games, this is the one for you, because you have to think about your distance, the wind speed, trajectory, inertia, like it all comes into play. So it's quite good there. quite a few guys here. How many shots do I have? 8 shots left. So there's a crew over here. It's cool too because of your heart rate. You can see in the bottom left it says 65 BPM. So if you run too much and your heart rate gets too high, then when you try to look down your scope, it's just swinging all over the place because he's trying to catch his breath. So here it's saying that it's good to take shots when there's a lot of noise because they won't be hearing it. That his heart rate has gone up to 70, but it's coming back down again. That was annoying. He must have heard the shots. Last scene. So if I move away from the area, we should have the all clear. Yeah. Uh-oh. That's the way I came from, okay.
Nanu?
Light it up! I'm ready!
Well, that wasn't good. I only have 5 shots left in this thing, too. I wonder if there's anything interesting here. Managing heart rate, right, so trying to keep it low moving, slow moving. Private Mark 4, so there you, Mark 3, so you can see that I haven't played this game too much. As I am mainly, oh, snap, snap, snap. Oh, he almost saw me. There he comes now. Actually, if I can make it out of this tent, I might be able to surprise attack.
Ich habe ihn entdeckt!
Nice. Okay, so let's go around here. Because I need to take out that last crew. Just kind of scouring.
Oh!
Another guy?
Oh, man.
He must have been from the tower or something. Still have to remember exactly, like, what... where I'm supposed to shoot at. What? That's crazy. Thank you. looks like I'm hitting. Oh, there we go. So maybe I was shooting a little bit too high. So in the crosshair, I think, yeah, the top T is what I'm going for there. Okay, let's switch out to this one here. That's that crew gone. Okay, so we gotta head down there. Am I in range with him? Apparently I am. So if I use my binoculars, usually, like, it'll tag victims for you, or enemies. All that I can see. Dynamite. So place dynamite with F or use F to throw.
Nebelwerf is neutralized. I might as well check the ridge.
There's nobody up on the tower. So if this is something that you guys enjoy, let me know, because I have a couple of other first-person shooters that I might be interested in bringing up on Feature Fridays. Oh, this guy was destroyed. Got a couple of other ones that might be nice to have. But mainly Total War is my game, so keep that content there. But it's always nice to kind of spice up the channel a little bit, not just have everything the same. There are some good mods that are coming out that I'm waiting for as well, such as Ancient Empires and some new Lord of the Rings, Total War Rise of War coming out. I'm excited for that as well. Unlock, got some trip mines. I do apologize. I did say that I was going to get the next episode of the Abdani campaign out. I will be recording that after this episode. I was just pretty busy and I wasn't able to get two videos out in that day. So I will try and record it after this and then get it out Saturday morning, which would be tomorrow morning. And if not, then I will for Sunday for sure. So don't worry, it will come this week.
We lost to Brooke, but my work had drawn the attention of British naval intelligence. They've been following one of Hitler's protégés sent to Africa, a ruthless advocate of nerve agents in the last war, General Franz Wallen. Their informant, close to Wallen, has gone dark, so they want me to investigate. My first port of call is the Gaborone Oasis, an Axis transport hub. Scout teams and commanders pass through here, along with intel. I have the cover of darkness on my side. There's a few officers in the area, so that's where I'll start my search. I can see plenty of elevation around the lake, perfect to set up my rifle. If Valen's been here, there'll be a trail, and I'll find it.
Fair enough. So I'm pretty happy with my loadout. I don't know if I can really change much as far as my sniper rifles go. There's a lot more wobble. Italian bolt-action rifle with high muzzle velocity and high recoil. Wow, that is a lot of wobble. We can try that and see. And MP40, better accuracy, less range, but I won't really need that for range. Yes, definitely that. Oh, except that's silent though. Yeah, we'll just stick with that. Stick grenade, med kit. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, so stick grenade, bandage, med kit. So that's good. Okay, so we'll try out that rifle and see how it goes.
It's loud enough to cover my rifle fire.
So I can try and see if we can tag some enemies first. We got one there.
This is a good place to use my binoculars.
Way ahead of ya. Yeah, there's a guy there.
Mm-hmm.
that's all that I see. So I guess we'll go for this guy first. Shot through the tent of this guy. But we can try and go here. Hopefully he's not chatting with Buddy.
Something to collect from his corpse.
Nice. Okay, we'll get out the silencer. Yes, this game is really slow paced. Like I said, it's all about taking your time, just like Splinter Cell. Enemies will find you based on noise generated by your shots. Yes. So first shot, second shot, third shot. So they're drawn basically to the fire. So they're smarter bots than usual. So you just have to move away from where you were taking your shots before, and then hide, and should be good to go. Three other objectives. I'll probably go for the first one and then end the episode, because I'm pretty sure we can save and quit whenever. So we'll go for one more and then I'll end the episode here. So I guess we'll go for the one that's 100 meters away. Can you not jump over that? Can you get around that? Oh, there we go. Or maybe, can we not go past that? Maybe we have to go this way, possibly. wife's dead. Oh, there's a guy there. There's a good vantage point for sniping. To find a way to get up there. Oh, there's a guy. There's two guys over here, too. Have to try to sneak up and around. Just make sure no one's behind here. See if I can get up this way. This guy's gonna get suspicious now.
Guter Mann.
Oh no.
Phew.
That was close. Right up there, but I should be able to get a good vantage point and then use the noise of that machine to get the kill. Just don't want to rush it. That's why I was the worst at playing Splinter Cells, because all I did was just rush the guy. They'd always be like, "Oh, Fisher, you weren't supposed to kill anyone in that level." I was like, "Well, what's the point of playing then?"
Trap here will cover me in case of a sneak attack. Watch it. Officers have keener sight than their men.
Officers boost their squad's vision range, making the squad more formidable. Interesting.
Swimming lessons. I better move.
I did not see the other one that was sitting with him.
Oh, shoot.
Not did he?
Oh, there's somebody coming up.
Who's this then?
You're getting brave.
Continuate a cercare. Attenti a dove mettete i piedi. Ho sentito qualcosa. Effettuate una perlustrazione dell'aria.
Shoot.
Er ist hier irgendwo.
Achtsam bleiben.
Da ist er!
Durchkämmt das ganze Gebiet.
Die Schüsse kamen von da.
Seht mal da drüben nach.
Was war
das? It's just like a flock of turkeys.
Bleibt in Deckung.
Come on up.
Weitersuchen. Passt auf, wo ihr hintretet.
Oh, shoot.
Weitersuchen.
Four more shots with this silenced pistol, which is kind of sucky. sniper shots. At this point, I might as well just go for it. I don't think there's enough guys that I would be killed. Grab that ammo, search the body. Boom, recruitment drive. I'm glad Valen's lackey is out bothering other outposts. Every time I see him, we lose more men in the name of stupid orders from Berlin. Very nice. So I'm gonna leave the video here, guys. If you did like Sniper Elite 3's content on my channel, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more, and I will see you guys in the next one.